The next question is, what is ADAM and why is it used most of the time in neural networks? So ADAM is an adaptive optimization algorithm that is known for its dynamic learning adjustments based on the first and the second moments of the gradients. So ADAM, like RMSProp, is another adaptive optimization algorithm which adapts the learning rate accordingly in order to reduce the amount of oscillations and to improve the optimization algorithm's quality. What ADAM tries to do is that it tries to bring these benefits of two different algorithms together. It tries to combine the idea of momentum from SGD with momentum with the idea of the RMSProp by using the running average of the second order derivative, so the second moment. And by combining the two, it tries then to take the benefits of these two worlds. So when it comes to the ADAM, it can be represented by this mathematical representation. You don't need to know it, but I always think it helps to bring perspective to how it combines the two worlds, the RMSProp and SGD with momentum, and why it is actually so useful. So when we look in here, we can see that the first one is the momentum term. So the mt is equal to beta 1 times mt minus 1 plus 1 minus beta 1 times gt, where the beta 1 is the first parameter, which is simply a constant. And the beta 2 is also a constant, a hyperparameter, both of which we can actually tune. So in here, you can see gt and gt squared, which are simply the first moment and the second moment of our gradients, where second moment is known to be better estimate, less noisy compared to the first moment. So what we are trying to do is that we are, on one hand, using this idea of momentum in order to reduce the amount of oscillations that the optimization algorithm is making. And in this way, we are improving the optimization process and getting a better quality. And on the other hand, we are also introducing this idea of velocity, which comes from the RMSProp, which then will result in better, less noisy estimate of the gradients. So by doing this, what we are trying to do is that we are adjusting the learning rate throughout the training process, and we are making it more effective across different scenarios. So for scenarios where SGD with momentum would have been better, ADAM will incorporate this. And where it would be beneficial to use RMSProp, then ADAM would again add the other optimization algorithms. And that's why ADAM has been proven across the entire industry to be very effective. And people are using it across the industry for a wide range of problems and applications. So as you can see, once we have our running average for the first order derivative and the running average for our second moment gradient, then we are also adjusting, so we are correcting this momentum and the velocity by dividing this mt. So we are taking the mt and we are dividing it to 1 minus beta 1t because we want to adjust for the bias when it comes to this momentum. And then we are also adjusting the velocity. So vt hat is then the adjusted version of the vt because we take the vt and we divide it to 1 minus beta 2 to the power t by using the beta 2 as our hyperparameter, as our second bias vector. And then we are using this adjusted running average for the first moment and the adjusted version of the running average of our second order gradient in order to update and adapt our learning rate. And as you can see here, what we are doing, we are taking the learning rate alpha, we are multiplying it by the adapted and adjusted momentum term, and then we are dividing it to the square root of this velocity term, or vt hat, plus some epsilon, which is usually a small number, just to ensure that we are not dividing this number to zero. And we are using this to subtract from the theta t, so the current parameter, to get our new updated parameter theta t plus 1. So when it comes to the benefits of using the ADAM, first of all, ADAM incorporates these benefits from multiple optimization algorithms to ensure that the quality is in place and the efficiency is in place, and the optimization algorithm is able to handle different scenarios. The efficiency with sparse gradients is another advantage of ADAM optimizer, because ADAM is particularly efficient when dealing with this sparse gradient. And the other advantage of ADAM is that it's able to balance the speed and the stability. So ADAM generally converges much faster when it comes to the converging to the global optimum compared to algorithms such as HGD. And at the same time, it also tends to be more stable because it's able to control the learning process compared to the algorithms that only use the first moment, whereas the ADAM is also using the second order gradients. So the second moment. And the final advantage of ADAM is that it is robust. So it's known for its robustness in various conditions and various scenarios, which also means that it is less sensitive to hyperparameter choices. And this is especially important when it comes to the initial learning rate. And this makes it much more easy and user-friendly for a large range of applications, especially when you are someone who is just learning deep learning. Then it can be a bit difficult to tune your hyperparameters. It can be difficult to identify these initial values that you need to use for your algorithm. And ADAM is then less sensitive to this choice of learning rate, which can be really important.